We are learning new details about the two men killed in an explosion at a landscaping business in Hopkinton.
Investigators say the men died after using a torch to open a safe that was full of fireworks. Ray Brewer joins us live in the studio with the latest. And Ray, we're now learning that both of those men had recent run-ins with the law.
That's right. And one of them, Aaron, Ethan Keeler, had recently been arrested on the felony charge of receiving stolen property. Now, we spoke to a young woman who knew Keeler and didn't want to be identified. And she says it's difficult to believe that he would have been mixed up in something like this.
Investigators say the explosion that ripped through this garage at a Hopkinton landscaping business early Tuesday morning was caused by two men trying to break into a 4-foot-high concrete lined safe.
These two male gentlemen were attempting to gain entry into a locked safe with an oxyacetylene torch, and the safe contained fireworks.
The resulting blast killed the two men and caused significant damage to the garage. The men did not have permission to be on the property. One of them's been identified as 21-year-old Ethan Keeler of Epsom. Concord police arrested Keeler in July for passing a bad check at a bank on Sheep Davis Road.
That would have been forgery and theft by deception. And then later in October, he was charged with receiving stolen property.
Those who knew Keeler in high school describe him as a friendly young man who was into sports.
Really, you never think anything like that would happen to someone you know, but it did happen, so it's kind of like still shocking, unbelievable. You guys still can't believe it happened.
The other man killed in the explosion was 21-year-old Lucas Bork of Allenstown. Court paperwork from a minor violation earlier this year indicates that Bork was living at this Main Street apartment building in June and that he leaves behind a 2-year-old daughter.
Investigators say the fireworks that were in that safe were the kind of fireworks that you would find in a store. But when the torch heated things up, well, it essentially turned those fireworks into a bomb that went off. In the newsroom, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.